economic benefits. Pearls are beautiful. But there is one thing that's better than a pearl, and that's pearl jewellery. Now, follow me on my trusty broom broom scooter, because I'm about to show you a great place to get pearl jewellery in Broome. Well, we've arrived at the amazingly historic Holland Track. I've left Ross behind and picked myself up some real experts. We're en route to Fraser Range Station. We'll be stopping off at Mount Holland and we'll have a look and see what we can find along the way. Let's get out of here. Seatbelt. Bonjour à tous. Aujourd'hui, nous allons voyager en Europe sans quitter Australie. Suivez-moi. Check these out. Behind me, the Oz tent, which takes 30 seconds to assemble. Up here, the Howling Moon rooftop tent. This is the famous Kimberley camper. But no, I didn't sleep in any of these last night. My friend, Ross, organised far more traditional digs for my first night camping. The Aussie Outback Supplies swag. And I've got to say, sucked in, Ross, it was the best night's sleep I have ever had. Anyway, let's take a closer look at some of these. Cable Beach. It's 22 kilometres of pristine turquoise coastline. And it could be at the doorstep of your very own holiday home. Hassle-free, fully managed. And of course, when you're not using it, it can make you money as holiday accommodation for others.
And knead away.
Knead
roll it.
It,
yep.
Like
so
I'm making bread.
Bread.
Yeah. You know what? Look,
you are horrible.
It's twins, look.
You're a shocker.
I've just been informed that there's far easier ways to find a Brolla's Pearls in Geraldton, and Murchison Gold, and Argyle Diamonds. I'm off to get glammed up. Now this is more like it. If you're looking for the perfect souvenir of your holiday in the Midwest, you can do it in style at Leon Baker Jewellers.
Telethon takes stamina, Mel, doesn't it?
It certainly does. I want to know, in the audience, who's an all-nighter? Such a good effort. I've seen a few people nodding off, but just wanted to make mention, all night. Good on you guys.
Wow, the crowd love it.
And of course, there's many other cool vehicles to choose from, including this kickin' Jeep Wrangler. Soft top down, I'm out of here. WA is full of places out in the middle of nowhere that are chockers with history, and they're awesome to get to in your four-wheel drive. We've arrived at Cave Hill, it's absolutely amazing. We're gonna camp here tonight and have a bit of a sticky pick. I tell you what, after just over 2 months bashing through the bush, you'd want to have a mountain named after you. This is Mount Holland, and it's definitely one of the highlights along the Holland Track, even if it is blowing a gale. Woohoo! Here in WA, our quality of life is second to none. We really can have it all right here, right now. So why would we expect anything less? Well, this is our first morning at Fraser Range Station, and last night we slept in these old shearers' quarters, which were built in 1870. Now we're about to go and have a look around the station right now, and we've been told there are some awesome four-wheel drive tracks. So I am going to get my first go driving a four-wheel drive.
So you're just going to take it real slow. You can brake a little.
I forgot about the brake.
That's okay, but we'll go straight up the same brake now.
Okay.
So when you go, turn a little bit that way.
Wow!
Go for it. Go.
Whoa!
That'll do.
It's all right. I did it.
You did it.
What do you reckon? Would you let me do it again?
Yes. Possible.
The path the Holland Track took was largely influenced by holes like these. They're called Nama holes. Aboriginal people have been using them for millions of years to get water. Now they're formed in some rocky outcrops by the rock eroding away and the rains filling them up. Now, John Holland would have followed these Nama holes all the way to Coolgardie, so all the early prospectors would have had a path to follow, places to rest and water to drink along their way to finding the gold. And check this out. That is one deep Nama hole. And you can see around here there's a bit of a structure that's been made This would have happened so you can put a cover over the top, and in summer, the Namahole won't evaporate. Have plenty of water. Ooh, it's cold!
So, what can you do with 5 days and a four-wheel drive in the southeast of Western Australia? Oh, I cooked damper, slept in a swag, I got fogged in, winched out of, and airborne over a ditch, and I had a whole heap of fun, all in my own backyard. Can't wait for the next camping trip.